Hi, my name is Dr. Nagarjuna. Welcome to the YouTube channel. Today we discuss about most common topic, emollients usage in newborns. So what is an emollient? An emollient is an agent that softens and smoothens the skin. They are also referred to as moisturizers and lubricants. They are essentially composed of lipids, which may be animal or vegetable, are obtained from mineral oils, or alternatively may be synthetic in nature. Emollients can be of following kinds: hydrocarbons such as vaseline or paraffin, fatty substances such as cetyl or stearyl alcohol, waxes such as bee wax or lanolin. Lanolin is obtained from sebaceous glands of sheep. Oils such as mineral oils, vegetable oils such as coconut oil, palm oil, groundnut oil, olive oil, mustard oil, synthetic oil. Two important types of emollient formulation. They are oil in water emulsion, what we call cream. In this, water is the major component. Water in oil emulsion, what we call ointment, in which oil is the major component, out of which cream preparations are generally preferred because the other preparations, which are ointment, would be occlusive in hot Indian weather. Various factors like bathing in hot water, frequent washing and use of harsh detergent, exposure to low humidity like air-conditioned environment and cold climate will worsen the dryness of the skin. Washing the skin with soaps removes the lipids and natural moisturizing factor, resulting in an increase in the pH of stratum corneum and altered hemostasis of the skin. Hence, liquid cleansers are, if not affordable, judicious use of mild cleanizing bars would be the ideal recommendation in babies prone for dry skin. Dry skin leads to micro and macro fissure formation, which result in easy penetration of allergen and bacteria. The application of an emollient serves the following purposes. It is safe and effective way to decrease neonatal peeling, scaling dermatitis, maintains barrier function, reduces irritation in the napkin area, and also has a role in massage. Routine application of emollients after bath at least twice weekly is recommended. If family history of atopy, apply emollient daily after bath. Natural olive oil and mustard oil have been used for many years as emollients traditionally in many parts of India. Studies have shown that they disturb the skin barrier and hence should not be used. Vegetable oils high in linoleic acid such as safflower oil or sunflower oil are recommended for infant skin. Mineral oil has been found to be effective skin moisturizer by virtue of emollient and occlusion property. It has limited penetration, does not contain the carcinogenic polyaromatic hydrocarbons, and found to be very safe. Skin barrier recovery occurs faster with sunflower seed oil and petrolatum, whereas it gets delayed with mustard seed oil, soya bean oil, and olive oil. That's why we will not promote mustard seed oil and olive oil as an emollient. Moreover, oleic acid content of olive oil inhibits synthesis of arachidonic acid, increases membrane permeability, and total epidermal water loss. Mineral oil has been found to be an effective skin moisturizer by virtue of emollient and occlusion property. So which emollient should be selected? Appropriately selected emollients, which are petroleum based, water miscible, and free of preservatives, dyes, and perfumes, could be used. Most importantly, it should be free of preservatives, dyes, and perfumes. Maintain sterility by ordering individual specific containers. That means the containers cannot be shared by different individuals in the family, because each individual or newborn will have specific skin flora, or if has to be shared by different members in the family, at least we should decanting products onto a paper towel prior to the application. Thank you for watching the video. Most of the guidelines are taken from Indian Academy of Pediatrics and Indian Standard Pediatric Textbooks.